Hello and welcome to Service Studio Overview. So what is Service Studio? Service Studio is the IDE that you use to develop in OutSystems. This is the component of OutSystems that allows you to visually design your data, design your interfaces, build up your logic, write the processes and any other asynchronous tasks that will run in the platform, and finally publish and debug these applications in the server. While the platform side of OutSystems is installed on your enterprise servers, you will need to install Service Studio in the developer machines. And once you launch Service Studio, you will need to connect to the server that you mean to publish your applications to. So this is how Service Studio looks like. Let's go through the several panels that you see in the IDE. This is the Elements tree area. This is where you'll go to select which elements in your module you will want to edit and modify. Once you find the element and double-click on it, you will start editing it in the editor area. There are several kinds of editors depending on the type of element that you are editing. So if you're editing logic, you will see an action editor. If you're editing a query, you'll see an aggregate editor and so on. But let's drill down on the most complex of the editors and the one you will likely spend most of your time, the screen editor. The two most important sections in the screen editor are the toolbox, which is on the left-hand side that holds the widgets, and the canvas that is the biggest section in the screenshot where you will build up your screen. Constructing your screen is mostly made up of dragging and dropping widgets from the toolbox into the canvas. Across the top, you have the views buttons that allow you to preview this screen as seen by several kinds of devices. You have the styles buttons that allow you to format the text and the elements on your screen. Still at the top, there's the breadcrumb that shows the path to the current element being edited, in this case, the movie screen. And across the bottom, you have the breadcrumb of the widget hierarchy. This will help you navigate up and down across the HTML elements of your screen. It's worth noting that when you're editing logic, you will still have a toolbox, a canvas, and the edited element breadcrumb. But instead of dragging widgets to a screen, you'll be dragging statements into your logic. Now, if you notice, there is a small toggle button on the top right-hand corner. This button, when pressed, will substitute the elements tree by the widget tree. This will give you full structured access to all the widgets inside your screen and will make up for a very convenient navigation tool. On the bottom right hand corner, there's the properties area. Regardless of the kind of element that you have selected in Service Studio, this is where you're gonna go to set its properties. Anything from what variable feeds a widget to what argument you're passing to a parameter in a piece of code that you're calling. At the bottom, we have the true change and debug area, and we'll talk a little bit more about this in a few slides. And at the very bottom, you have the status bar where you can see to which server you're connected and which user you're using to connect to this server. So these are all the panels that you will see in the main area of the Service Studio IDE. Let's look now at the Workspace tabs that sit at the very top of Service Studio. The leftmost tab takes you to the OutSystems Forge. As we mentioned before, this is the go-to place to get extra widgets, extra connectors, and sample applications to improve your development. Next up is the ever-present Environment tab that is a window to the server that you're connected to. At root level, you'll be able to see all the applications that the current user can access in the current environment, install applications from the Forge, and create a new application. When you create a new application or you edit an existing application, this tab changes to the application details, where you'll be able to see and edit things like the application icon, the description, the modules that make up this application, and also see what dependencies this application has with other applications. Finally, you may have one or more module tabs. When you select one of these tabs, you will be editing that particular module. Now, between the workspace tabs and the main editor area, there is the menu bar. While on the left-hand side of the menu bar, you see the habitual drop-down menus and accelerators, I want to call to your attention the right-hand side, where the layer buttons are. Selecting a layer will take you to the domain of that particular layer. It will change the elements tree to display the elements of that particular layer. So in the Data tab is where you will do all your data modeling. Likewise, any global resources that your module has will be created over here. The Logic tab is all about code. This is where you're going to create logic that can be called from anywhere on your module, as well as set up web services, both exposed and consumed. Security roles and exceptions that your code may throw are also defined here. On the Interface tab, you will see all the screens, images, and themes that your module has. So anything related with UI will be inside this layer. Finally, the Processes tab holds everything that is asynchronous in the OutSystems platform, be it business processes or asynchronous tasks that we call timers. On the right-hand side of the layers, there's a very handy tool, which is the search tool that will allow you to globally search inside your module for everything from strings to names of elements. Now, you're doing your developments, you're creating your application bit by bit. How do you actually publish this application to the OutSystems server? First, you need to deal with any errors that your application might have. While you're developing, Service Studio is consistently making syntax and semantic validations of your module, and you can see at the bottom the True Change panel that highlights not only warnings but errors that you need to address prior to publication. Once your module has no errors, you will see that that top button will turn into the one-click Publish button. Pushing this button will initiate the publication. Service Studio will connect to your server, send your module over, and our compiler will generate optimized code, pages, and the changes to the database needed to run this new version of your code. All of this will be deployed in the appropriate servers with just one click in Service Studio. Let me just open a quick parenthesis to talk to you about comparing and merging. If ever more than one developer is working on the same module, conflicts might occur. So someone might have published the current module while you were developing, and as you publish, you are notified that someone did. In face of this, you need to decide if you want to just go ahead and publish your current version or merge the changes that the other developer has done and are available in the server. And for this, you have the compare and merge feature. In this screenshot, you can see compare and merge in action. So on the left-hand side, you have everything that's in your current module, while on the right-hand side, you have everything that's on the published on the server side. Merge will use information from the common ancestor to suggest what you should keep on both sides, but you can always overwrite and pick and choose whatever it is that you will want on the published version. It's worth noting that while compare and merge is normally launched when the conflict is detected, at any time you can launch it on demand if you want to pull in code from modules in the server or even on your local machine. Simply use the appropriate button in the menu bar. Once any conflicts are dealt with, publication starts and you can follow its progress in the True Change area at the bottom. Upon publication success, the one-click button changes to the Open in Browser button. If you press it, your browser will launch the current application and you'll be able to test it immediately. And that's the Service Studio IDE in a nutshell. See you in the next lesson.